Hello, my name is Philip and at the moment I'm finishing my master degree on computer science at the University of Applied Science and Arts in Dortmund. In the next about 15 to 20 minutes I want to talk about viewpoint-specific microservice modeling. For this purpose I will start with a short introduction of model-driven development in microservice architecture, followed by an explanation of the running example which I keep using in my presentation and the demonstration of our modeling languages. For this purpose, I want to start with the presentation of the domain data service and meta model we created, followed by an actual demonstration of our modeling languages in the Eclipse development environment. I will finish my presentation with a conclusion and a discussion at the end. So model-driven development is in general an approach to software engineering. It abstracts from implementation in details by the usage of models, and these models provide a viewpoint-specific understanding of the software system. And this can be beneficial for engineering complex and distributed systems. As an architecture for distributed systems, microservice architecture can benefit from this approach. It increases the efficiency of service identification and model value, and it reduces the efforts and costs of architectural definitions. It facilitates the exchange of technology used for the actual realization of a microservice, and increases the quality of the software we want to develop. Furthermore, it reduces the conceptual clutter we create by modeling microservice architecture, and we want to reuse our models we created across different viewpoints on the actual software system. So the running example is the Park and Charge system. The Park and Charge system is a platform for providing charging points for electric vehicles to other people. For example, if you're the owner of an electric vehicle and you go to work, the charging point in front of your home is unused and can be potentially used by other people. So the platform is organized into four different services: the charging point management service, who deals with all concerns regarding the usage of the charging points; the user management service does the user management; the search service is responsible for finding a charging point in a certain area; and the booking service does all the billing stuff for the usage. So the whole system is developed as a distributed system based on microservice architecture, and each of the service is developed by a single team. The teams are using the DevOps paradigm for the development and operation strategy, and the technology stack of each service is independent. So if we take a look at the whole team organization and modeling aspects in DevOps-based teams for microservice architecture, we have different team roles. For example, a domain expert, a service developer, and a service operator. These people all have a different viewpoint on the system. The domain expert is more interested in the domain concept the application is applied to, and the service developer is more interested in the actual development of these services. And the operator does all the operational stuff. The different members have viewpoint-specific models which are suited for their actual means. So the domain expert builds a domain model which encapsulates all the important domain concepts in one model, and the service developer is also interested in this model because he needs to use this information to develop the actual service. The domain model is based on the domain modeling languages, which are based on the domain data meta model. This is for all our provided modeling languages the same. So if we take a look at the meta models, I will start with the domain data meta model. It is mainly focused around the primitive and complex data type. The primitive data types is, for example, a Boolean or a float, and the complex data types allows us to model complex data structures. Additionally, we can import other complex data structures. For example, if we have shared entities between the microservices, for example, a location or a user, we can import the data types and use it in our domain model with a service specific. Additionally, we provide a versioning system to support different versions of the model. And for organizational aspects, we provide a context. The context corresponds with the bounding context, which we all know from domain-driven development. Yes, the second meta model is a bit more complex and is responsible for the modeling of the services. The whole meta model is focused around the microservice concept. And microservice in general has a specific endpoint assigned. This endpoint can be specified about interfaces and operations which are included in this interface. And we can specify the endpoints of the interfaces and the operations separately. Additionally, we have to specify how we can access the interface by the usage of a protocol and a specific data format this operation is used. To enable the reuse of the domain data model, we can import this model and use the different complex data types the domain expert and the service developer created in the modeling of the actual service. Additionally, it is possible to import other services to our service model to show dependencies to these models. Yes, and this model is this meta model provides the service modeling languages, which I'll later presentate by the usage. So the last meta model I want to show is the operation meta model, which deals with all concerns regarding the actual deployment and use of the service. First of all, we have to import the service we want to deploy. This works about the imported microservice concept, and then we have to specify the deployment technology and the operation environment. For example, we want to deploy our microservice by the usage of Docker. And the service is running using the Java JDK operation environment. The last point is we have to define the basic endpoint which our microservices is accessible over. For example, HTTP parkandchargesystem.org. And we have to specify some service property and protocols. So let's demonstrate the actual usage of the modeling languages which we created. For this purpose, I switch into the Eclipse development environment. The role meta models and modeling languages are created and implemented by the usage of Xcore and the Xcore framework from the Eclipse DSL tools, and in this specific example, I'm showing the common context which is shared between the different microservices. I assigned a specific version to our microservice and created a context. In the context, we are now allowed to specify the different complex and primitive data types, and in this example, I created the complex data type of a time period. The time period includes two attributes a start time and an end time, and it can be used for showing the usage of a charging point, for example. The next modeling language is the service modeling languages, and at this point we have at first the possibility to import the domain data model. We have to specify it using the domain data modeling languages. Additionally, we are importing several microservices which our charging point microservice depends on. And technology. The technology was not actual part of the paper we presented, but it's part of our current work, so I included it in this example. By defining a microservice, we first have to specify what kind of microservice is it. For example, a functional microservice or an infrastructural microservice. And then we have to assign a specific name and a version again. Then we have the possibility to model the services our microservices depends on. And at this, I included all the infrastructural microservice our microservice need to function, for example, as a security service or a discovery service. To use a more specific dependency modeling, we also able to show the dependencies to other interfaces of microservice. And at this point, our microservice depends on the user management interface, who is responsible for managing all concerns regarding the users of the platform. The last possibility to model dependencies is to address a specific operation of an interface of a microservice. At this point, I'm saying I want to use the update user information of the user management service. As we know, we get a warning that we included this actual operation by referring the interface that this operation is located in. So the next point I want to show is how to specify a specific interface in a microservice. For this purpose, we have to specify an endpoint for this interface and assign an actual technology to it. In this example, we use the REST protocol in the interface. The next step is defining the operation which are included in this interface. In this example, we specify the technology again which the interface uses, which the operation uses. In this case, it's REST again, and we have to specify the communication mechanism, for example, synchronous communication, and the ingoing and outgoing data the operation needs. In this case, it's the creation of a charging point, and it gives the actual created charging point in the software system back. So this was the usage of the service modeling language, and the last modeling language is the operation. For this purpose, we have to first include the actual service we want to deploy by this deployment specification, and we have to include the use technology for the deployment. In the next step, we are saying we want to deploy our microservice by the usage of the technology Docker and the operation environment Java JDK. After this, we have to specify which specific microservice we want to deploy. And this is the charging point management service. And we have to specify the endpoint which is our microservice accessible over. And this is this. So let's continue with the presentation. So to sum this presentation up, at first we gave a short introduction of model-driven development for microservice architecture. And then we showed how the different viewpoint modeling in DevOps teams is possible. After that, we explained the different meta models our modeling languages are based on. And then we showed their actual usage. So what do we plan in future? We want to integrate our approach into an agile modeling process. And I think the most important part is to implement some code generators to get all the benefits of the created models and generate some software, some code to facilitate the development process of the actual microservices. So this was my presentation, and are there any questions?
Thank you for your presentation. Am I wrong to say there is a top-down approach? So you design everything on top, and then gradually you get more and more details on
yes.
That. Is that correct? Have you thought to do vice versa from the code and go up?
No, it was more of a top-down approach. We thought about the code generation at last. We built first the domain data model, and then the service model, because the domain data model gets imported in the service model, like the service model is imported in the operation model. And after all these models are needed for generating the actual code, because these models are acting like an holistic approach. We need all the information to write the code generator, because when we leaving out the operational part, there are some blank spaces in the code which we can't generate and which we have to assume for the generation. And I think that is some kind of complicated, because the assumptions are not really known of the person who creating the models. So it's a little bit misleading the other way, I think.
Yes, but if you try to apply this on something that exists already, on an architecture that exists already,
yeah.
How would you go? You can't, I suppose you couldn't ask to redesign the entire architecture to fit on your own.
Okay. I think when you have on an already existing architecture, it would be a good approach to first model the actual existing architecture, and from there on generating some part of the aspects which are going to be included in the system, and not to include all at once.
Any other questions?
Hi, yeah, that was a very interesting presentation. So when you talk about the future goals and code generation, are you thinking about stuff like generating Docker Compose files or Kubernetes deployment descriptors?
Yes, of course. The operational model, I think it's a very important part to generate these artifacts, because the deployment somehow specifies the environment or the whole infrastructure our services are working in. So yes, of course, by the deployment model, it would be easy possible to generate some, for example, Kubernetes deployment file, because we can specify the actual Docker container which the deployment is using. Then we can define the endpoints, and it's possible. Yes, we think that that's including in this operation model to find something like that.
Okay, then I have one follow-up question. How would you describe things like configuration and secret management, which we need to do on Kubernetes, for example?
Oh, that's an important question, but I think it is, I skipped the technology description of the services, and it's possible to find some aspects, and these secret management could be easily done by the usage of these aspects. For example, the aspect could be an actual username by the foreign database, for example. But maybe when I show you how it can done, we talk about later in detail.
Yeah, thank you.
Any other questions? Then let's thank Philip again.